Common question we get for storyline drag and drops is how to reset only the incorrect choices. Now, this isn't something that's baked into storyline by default, but using some motion paths along with some conditional triggers, we can create that same effect to give learners a second chance at getting their interaction correct. Let's take a look at how it works. Okay, so I'm here in Storyline, and I have some simple shapes just set up here on the slide. I'd like to drag each of these over to their target and just evaluate whether or not they're in the right target. If not, we're going to reset those back to the starting position. So a couple things I want to do. First, I'm going to convert this to a freeform, which is by far the fastest way to create drag and drops in Storyline. So head on up here to the Insert tab and choose Convert to Freeform. First option, selected drag and drop is what we want, so click OK. And now I just need to quickly wire up my drag items with my drop targets. I'm just going to go through the list real quick. You can see how I give each of these a common prefix in the name. That makes it really easy to quickly find the objects you're looking for. So I'm just going to hit all my drag items right now. So all three of my drag items are selected. Hop over here to drop target, and we just go drop one, drop two, and drop three. Since I want to give my learners two attempts, at least two, I'm going to modify that right here to two, and that'll create the try again layer in my slide view. So that's good right there. And I think I can leave everything here for drag and drop. Okay, if you want to return the item, you can do that. I think I'm going to choose snap to center for my target options. Click okay, and let's pop back over here to slide view. And I'm going to make a change real quick to my drag items. I want to add a built-in state for drop correct. So come down here to states, choose edit states, and I'm going to create a new state. So the new state, and I'll find that from the drop-down menu. Just come down here to drop correct, and I'll just give it a color, a little color difference. So under the format tab, we can choose green. And here's where you have a chance. If you want to show the incorrect feedback, you could also add a second state for drop correct and then say drop incorrect. And then we can give that a different color. All right. Now that that's set up, I'm just going to use the Format Painter to quickly apply those two new states I created to my remaining two buttons. So select the first button, come up here to the Home tab, double-click the Format Painter. By double-clicking it, it'll remain persistent, and we can quickly click once, cool, click two, click away. So now I've added those states really quickly to each of these objects. Okay, so the way we want to make this happen and to reset these, there's a couple ways. One way that I've shown in the past is to use a variable and then reset the slide. A little simpler way is just to use a motion path. So let me show you what that's going to look like. I'm going to select this first shape and come up here to the Animations tab on the ribbon. I'm going to add a motion path, and just a basic one is fine. But here's what we're going to do. You see how the motion path's coming all the way down here? Instead, what I'm going to do for length is I'm going to set that to 0. So the motion path is really going nowhere. Now, if you wanted to make this maybe 0.1 or something really short, you could do that as well. But when we're going to reset this along the motion path, it's going to force this object to jump back from whichever target it's been dropped in. Now, I do want to change the duration to something really short. So I'll make that 0.1. And thankfully, we can, in Storyline 360, we can name our motion path. So I'm going to call this one Path01. And that'll make it really easy to find that. Now, to quickly paste that motion path on the other objects, I'm going to come over here to Animation Painter, and I'm going to click once on Drag 2. So everything else is the same, right? The motion path is the same. It's going to be a length of 0, a duration of 0.10, but it does add a extra 1 to that name, so I'm just going to type Path02. Cool. And then finally, we'll do it one more time to add it to Drag 03. So select the Animation Painter, and then click once on that. And I'm just going to come up here real quick and then rename that to Path03. And that'll just make it so much easier for us to address and find each of the paths in the trigger panel. Okay, so by default, if you look down here, the motion path is starting along the timeline. But we don't need this to move here on this path. So I'm just going to delete these. So delete that one, delete the next one, and then finally the third one, because I don't need this to move when the slide first loads. I do want it to move when we hit the try again layer. So notice that we have the drop correct and incorrect states right here. I'm gonna come over here to the try again. And what I wanna do is add triggers that tell these three choices we have, these three choices, drag one, two, and three, to play on, to move, which is the trigger, to move on that animation path when the slide loads, only if the state is not drop correct. So let me show you what that looks like. New trigger, and we'll start with the first one, move. So just come down here for move. So move, and we'll move the drag item, that first one, along path one, which is the path that we gave it, when the timeline reaches, and we'll just say point. Now it's not showing that. I'm gonna click here, and I just wanna make sure that that says point one. So it wasn't picking up the point in the triggers panel. So I'll have to take a look at that. But now we have a move that when the timeline reaches on this layer, 0.1 seconds, move that item. But we do need a condition, so I'm gonna pop this back open again. And the condition is, if it's not in a drop correct state. Remember those custom color states that we added? So we want to evaluate whether or not it was dropped on the correct state. So we say object, and then we say drag one is not equal to drop correct, right? So if it's in the correct spot, I don't need to move it on that timeline because I don't want to reset it. I want to keep it in the same place. However, if it's incorrect, we do want to reset it, and that's what this timeline, the motion path, will do when we tell it to play. Cool. There's my first one. I'm just going to copy this one and paste it, double click it, and so you can kind of see this a little bit clearer. I'm going to say drag item two along path two when the timeline reaches the time. In this case, if drag two is not equal to drop correct. And then we'll paste it one more time and make that same change. Actually, I'll just do it in line right here since it'll be faster. We'll say drag three along path three if drag three is not equal to drop correct. I'm going to also come down here to the slide properties and just make sure that we reset everything when we revisit the slide. So I'm going to change that to reset to initial state, click close, and come back down here to my base layer. And I think we can give it a try. So let's preview the slide, see how it works. I think I got everything here. So let's just mix and match a few. We'll get the two up there. We'll get three correct, and then we'll have these two obviously in the wrong one. We click submit. You can see that the correct and incorrect state changes have taken place. When I click try again, everything, these two reset while this current drag is still in place. And now we can drop them into place. Now, that should be okay. A couple things you might do, and that just wants to jump to the next slide. So that should work. You might want to do a couple things where you, let me just show you a couple variations on it. And I think in the version we just did, you might not want to show a drop incorrect. Right, so maybe you just keep the same styling that you do for the normal, or maybe you keep it for all of these, but you do want to use at least the incorrect or the correct so that you can evaluate whether or not it's one of those. I like to evaluate whether it's not drop correct as opposed to incorrect, because sometimes if you drop the target anywhere else, it's possible that it gets marked as incorrect. So I would rather only look for the drop correct target to be changed. One other modification that you can do, I think on this one, let me come up here to the drag and drop options real quick and just and pop this open. You might want to not delay the feedback. So as soon as they put it on a target, they can actually get that visual feedback. And that kind of gives them enough of a clue maybe that they don't need to go ahead and submit, right? So if I put it on any of these as incorrect, then I get that visual feedback. So then in a sense, you don't have to do all the thing that we're just doing with the reset. But that's another option for them. One other thing, I'm going to put that back to delay the feedback. I did see one instance where some of the feedback was still changing. So you can see where I have this grayed out. I disabled the trigger. If you see that the state changes are not resetting back to normal, you might want to add a trigger that changes the states back to normal just in case it's not showing. I've had just kind of a couple times I saw it happen, didn't see it happen. Seems to be working fine right now. But if for any reason when you reset the slide after you hit the try again and it comes back here, and you still see these set up a certain way, if they're still showing the color and you don't want it, you can then manually force that to go back to normal. Okay, so just one way to reset the incorrect choices in a drag and drop in Storyline 360. Hope that helps.